So in this last video segment on the PPF, I want to go ahead and talk about what's going to happen to the PPF with either of the two following assumptions added. One assumption might be that we have what's called decreasing or diminishing returns. So the idea here is decreasing or diminishing returns describes a situation where when you first start doing something, you get a lot of bang for your buck. And then later on, you get less and less productive or less and less efficient as you do more of it. So that could be one thing. A prominent reason for having decreasing or diminishing returns could be that we have differentiated factors of production. And let's suppose we're going to think about, say, a country out there. We're going to think about, say, China. And we're going to think about China's PPF for two different crops. We're going to have rice and wheat. And as you may or may not know, rice likes swampy areas and wheat does not like swampy areas. So let's suppose that if China kind of divides up its land reasonably and it assigns the wheat growing to the non-swampy areas and the rice to the swampy areas grown in non-swampy, rice grown in swampy, it can grow this much rice and that much wheat. Now, notice we're assuming people are not stupid. An alternative way to split up production could be, well, let's grow the wheat in the swampy areas and let's grow the rice in the non-swampy areas. And so that might be a situation like this. And in that case, we get less of both goods. We're being sort of inefficient and stupid. So you can see why points that are interior to the PPF are going to be inefficient. It could be because we've organized our production badly. We're using all the land, but we've organized it badly. It could be also that, or some land is unplanted. So if we just let some factors of production sit idle, some workers are unemployed or something like that, that's going to go ahead and produce a situation where we're underperforming relative to our potential. So let's now think about, let's suppose China says, you know, we want to go ahead and increase our rice production. Well, in this case, we're going to now be planting rice in the non-swampy land where the rice does not grow as well. So if we were able to increase rice production by this amount, by planting it in the land where rice grows well, if we then go to plant rice in an area where rice doesn't grow well, we'll get a smaller increase in production. And that's exactly one of the reasons why differentiated factors of production, the land is a factor of production, and it's differentiated. Some land is better for some purposes than others. Why differentiated factors of production are going to lead to decreasing returns. And you can see that this arrow here is smaller than that arrow. That's the idea of diminishing returns. So it might be that the PPF goes like that. If we made the opposite choice, if we decided that, we wanted to just totally maximize our wheat production and give up on the idea of rice production at all. Well, we were able to increase wheat production by that much by planting wheat in all the land that was good for wheat. If we then go and try to increase wheat production further, we're probably going to get a smaller increase in production. So it might be our PPF looks something like this. So in this case, notice this PPF has a what we call bowed out shape. It's not a straight line. And that bowed out shape, again, is due to one of those things up there. And this implies that the opportunity cost of production is not constant. And in particular, the opportunity cost, let's suppose we start here, up in this corner. At first, as we start to try to get more rice, we only have to give up a relatively small amount of rice, only have to give up a relatively small amount of wheat to get a relatively large amount of rice. But for the next step here, to get a similar level of increase in the rice production, we have to give up more wheat. This down arrow here is bigger than that down arrow there. So you can see how the opportunity cost changes as you're going along the PPF. And there's a sense in which when you have this kind of bowed out shape to the PPF, it's going to steer you towards being somewhere in the middle, because to get those last few units of wheat or those last few units of rice, you have to give up a heck of a lot of the other good. And that's going to generally not be very appealing to you.